During a stormy night, Special Forces Agent Lin Dong is driving a car at high speed across town when he receives a phone call from Dr. Wu. Dr. Wu informs Lin Dong about his daughter Shishi, who is suffering from leukemia, saying that her condition is deteriorating as she goes into comatose. After the call, Lin Dong then races ahead toward the hospital. Just when he overcomes the traffic and reaches there, he receives another call from his colleague, Chao Su. Chao Su tells Lin Dong that their important witness, identified as Dr. James, has been exposed and is in danger. Dr. James is a reclusive biologist who has been secretly working for an arms dealer researching biochemical weapons. Lin Dong is then instructed to escort Dr. James to a high-security military base. He becomes torn between being with his daughter in her critical situation and accomplishing an important mission assigned to him. He weeps while staring at the hospital building, deciding to forego his personal matters as he drives off to meet with Chao Su and their team. Around the same time, Dr. James is inside his safe house. He takes along a mechanical device that looks like a heart and injects himself with a peculiar chemical fluid. The fluid kicks instantly in his system, and he starts foaming at his mouth. After a while, Lin Dong and his entire team finds him calmly sitting on his couch. They take the mechanical heart device and escort Dr. James out of his safe house when they are all suddenly ambushed by a group of men in black armor. These men with highly advanced weaponry are led by a mutated individual named Andre, who has been actively looking for Dr. James. Andre and his men have bombed the transfer vehicle for Dr. James before continuously shooting at the special agents. The special agents fire back at them, but their bullets cannot penetrate their black armor. Lin Dong steals a gun from one of Andre's men and manages to fight back shortly until he gets overpowered by Andre using his gun-type bomb. As Lin Dong collapses on the ground, Chao Su protects Dr. James by brawling with Andre, but to no avail. Andre approaches Dr. James, demanding him to hand over the mechanical heart device, but Dr. James resists, telling Andre that he is a devil. Andre furiously shouts at Dr. James, claiming that the scientist would not be able to successfully invent the device if it were not for him. Just before Andre can capture Dr. James, Lin Dong appears and drives his car to push Andre toward an oil tank. Despite that, Andre survives the crash and somehow is able to push the car away. In defense, Lin Dong shoots at the oil tank behind Andre, leading to a massive explosion in the area. Severely injured, Lin Dong lies on the ground in the rain, unable to answer his phone when it rings beside him. But Dr. James hears the call and picks it up instead, receiving the news that Lin Dong's daughter, Shishi, has died in the hospital that day. 13 years after the incident, Lin Dong relocated to Sydney, Australia. There, an author named Rick Rogers has just released his latest novel titled Bleeding Steel. The novel talks about a main character who was a US Marine before he died of nuclear radiation. But then some geneticists bought his body and turned him into a bioroid with a mechanical heart. It also contains the mechanical heart in its cover and explores topics on immortality and memories of others. Meanwhile, a young man named Li Sen takes interest in Roger's manuscript of The Bleeding Steel. He goes to Roger's hotel suite while disguised as a female prostitute and drugs him in order to acquire information about the book. At the same time, a woman dressed in full black clothing arrives at the hotel, brutally killing the security inside. Li Sen hides inside the large rose-filled bathtub just before the woman enters Roger's hotel room. The woman goes straight to Rogers and tortures him into telling her his source of inspiration in writing the book. Just then, Lin Dong, who has masked his entire face, emerges from the window and attacks the woman in black. As she falls to the ground, Lin Dong seizes the chance to ask Rogers about the original copy of Bleeding Steel. Rogers reveals that he just stole the story, pointing out that all the information is in his laptop. The woman in black rises to attack Lin Dong as Rogers gets killed by her in an instant. Lin Dong takes the laptop and attaches an explosive device on it before leaving the woman in the hotel suite. The woman is about to chase down Lin Dong, but she receives a message that the police officers are on their way, causing her to retreat. From inside the hotel suite, Lee Sen rises from the rose-filled bathtub and successfully retrieves the information by taking the laptop's storage drive. He hides himself in a black hoodie as he walks out of the hotel. Later, Lin Dong heads back to his apartment. He treats his injuries while listening to the news report about the murder of Rogers in his hotel suite. While the CCTV footage in the hotel has been suspiciously disabled, the police officers were able to acquire another footage from the nearby building, revealing Lee Sen's presence. Lin Dong then learns about the young man Lee Sen, who also happens to be inside the hotel suite at the time of the attack. Inside a high-technology aircraft, Andre is later shown to have survived the battle with Lin Dong. On the other hand, his severe injuries have turned him into a human with mechanical body parts. The woman in black, who turns out to be Andre's underling, returns to the aircraft and reports to him about the previously failed mission. She tells him of a masked man's interruption in interrogating Rogers. Andre utilizes his advanced technology and finds out that the masked man is Lin Dong. He is driven by grit to capture Lin Dong, swearing that he will make him suffer. The woman in black also tracks down the costume worn by Lee Sen, wherein she instantly finds his address. She goes to Lee Sen's stated address, only to find an abandoned apartment along with the costume that he wore in his disguise. Meanwhile, Lee Sen discovers that Roger's computer files mostly contain information about a young girl named Nancy. Curious about the retrieved information from Rogers, Lee Sen quickly follows Nancy on her way to school. At the same time, Lin Dong, working as a food server, appears inside the cafeteria where Nancy is. During lunch, he delightfully serves food to her while Lee Sen watches from a distance. Nancy later meets trouble when she bumps into another student. The student insults her with racist remarks, making her initiate a fight between them. The rest of the people in the canteen watch as Nancy and the other student engage in a catfight. Lee Sen later rushes in to assist Nancy while Lin Dong breaks up the fight between the two girls. Walking out of the canteen, Nancy looks at her wound as it heals quickly. The same day inside her dormitory, Nancy is revealed to be having continuous nightmares about a laboratory that conducts odd experiments. Her roommate wakes her up, and Nancy apologizes, telling her that the nightmares have gotten worse since she changed doctors. Her roommate reminds her that her previous doctor was not a real doctor, but instead a spiritualist, and tells Nancy not to talk to the spiritualist anymore before going back to sleep. However, Nancy does not listen and decides to visit the spiritualist again after her class. She walks toward dangerous hallways in order to reach the spiritualist's building. The spiritualist's assistant welcomes her inside. Later, she tells the spiritualist about her nightmares, which are turning more frequent and vivid. The spiritualist puts her under hypnosis when all of a sudden, Nancy starts having nightmares all over again. She dreams about Dr. James and his series of experiments conducted on Andre inside a laboratory. The spiritualist pokes a needle on her chest and concludes that there is another soul of a man inside Nancy. When she wakes up, the spiritualist informs Nancy that her case is beyond her powers and refers Nancy to a master of hypnosis, advising her to consult with him in the Sydney Opera House. After Nancy leaves, it is revealed that the spiritualist is recording tapes of Nancy's consultations and has been telling her dreams to Rogers, where he got his inspiration for Bleeding Steel. While on her way out of the building, Nancy is cornered by a group of pervert men. In turn, Nancy kicks one of the men in the groin before running away. The rest of the men chase her down until Lee Sen clumsily arrives to rescue her. Nancy sprays paint all over the men to help Lee Sen, and they successfully run away from them. The next day, Lee Sen follows Nancy to the opera house, where he manages to sneak the two of them inside. He tries to get to know Nancy, curiously asking for any information, but she ignores him. The two get separated when Lee Sen is mistaken as a technician and gets called to fix the equipment for the show. Later in the show, Nancy finds her way to the master of hypnosis, who calls her to the stage. Seemingly hypnotized, Nancy unconsciously approaches the master of hypnotism and takes the seat in the center. Little by little, her memories are unveiled before her, wherein Nancy is revealed to be Lin Dong's daughter, Shishi. She recalls her memories with her father in the hospital, but does not remember Lin Dong's face. Lee Sen watches her from the monitor when suddenly the woman in black shows up in the opera house and locates Nancy. She mercilessly kills the master while the audience inside the auditorium escapes warily. Just then, Lin Dong arrives and fights with the woman in black for the second time. Lee Sen assists Lin Dong by manipulating the stage equipment, activating the fireworks machine to distract her. However, she manages to take Nancy, who is still sleeping, and escapes with her. Lee Sen monitors Nancy's location and tells Lin Dong as the two of them team up to stop the woman in black from taking her away. Lin Dong fights with her as Lee Sen takes Nancy out of the opera house using a crib. Seeing her captive taken away, the woman in black faces Lin Dong furiously. The woman in black faces Lin Dong furiously, and the two of them continue their fight on the top of the Sydney Opera House. After much struggle, Lin Dong meets with Nancy and Lee Sen. They escape together on a motorboat. Lin Dong brings the two of them to his house, where he lays Nancy on a bed. Lee Sen, on the other hand, is dragged by Lin Dong to his high-security arsenal and gets locked inside. Lin Dong does not trust Lee Sen enough for him to be near his daughter Nancy. When Lin Dong asks him, Lee Sen reveals the information he knows regarding Rogers, sharing that when he went through Rogers' laptop, it contained Nancy's information, so he got curious about her. But Lin Dong still decides to keep Lee Sen locked inside his arsenal until he has verified his identity. Later, Lin Dong heads out to meet with the spiritualist. He visits the building where she was, only to find her and her assistant already dead. Eventually, he also finds out that the spiritualist has been selling Nancy's therapy videos to Rogers, where he based the story of the bleeding steel. Lin Dong comes back to his house, but discovers that Shishi has woken up and is no longer in the bedroom. He locates her using his tracker and learns that she is heading to Dr. James's abandoned safe house. While he prepares to leave and follow her, two armed men in black arrive and barge into his house. Lin Dong subdues them by escaping through the fireplace. He later boards a plane to Shingon City, where Dr. James's abandoned safe house is located. Meanwhile, Lin Dong recalls his memories 13 years ago. Back then, Lin Dong woke up in a hospital after being injured from the explosion of an oil tank. His old colleague, Chow Su, catches him up on what happened. As it turns out, the mechanical heart which Dr. James has held tightly is an immortality device that is designed to help the cells of the body continuously regenerate. When Dr. James found out about Shishi's death, he decided to attach the mechanical heart inside her body and injected the same immortality serum that he infused in himself. Shishi's vivid nightmares happened to be Dr. James's memories, which were imprinted in her after he used his bioengineered blood in resurrecting her. Andre is another experimental subject of Dr. James, who wanted to take and use the mechanical heart for his own benefit. While Shishi became the first and only successful test subject of Dr. James, she has lost all her old memories and does not remember her father, Lin Dong. Even so, Lin Dong instructed Chow Su to bring Shishi to an orphanage in Australia, protecting her from any impending attacks from Andre, and he has quietly watched over Shishi through the years. At present, Lin Dong reaches Shingon and is reunited with his colleague, Chow Su. Chow Su reports to him her investigation on Lee San's identity, but she is unable to retrieve much information about him. Meanwhile, Shishi has arrived at Dr. James's previous safe house, where she is able to recall all her old memories and retrieve an old key to a bank vault. She cries after finally remembering her father, Lin Dong, who she noticed to have been with her all along. However, before Lin Dong could arrive at the safe house, the woman in black tracks Shishi and kidnaps her. She brings her inside a car, which Lin Dong later follows. Lin Dong drives at a full speed as a car chase ensues between him and the woman in black's convoy. Lee Sen, who managed to free himself from the arsenal, appears on the road and intercepts the woman's vehicle. However, Shishi is no longer inside the car as she is brought to Andre's aircraft. On the other hand, the woman in black and her guards proceed to the bank vault in which Dr. James has stored a video camera. Just then, they are locked inside by Chow Su as the special agents surround the bank vault. As Lin Dong and Lee Sen reunite, the tracker leads them to the bank vault. Chow Su and the special agents subdue the woman in black and her guards. They also retrieve the video camera, which Dr. James has hidden away. The video camera includes a detailed explanation of Dr. James on his research about regeneration, including the experiment conducted on Andre. Dr. James aimed at making Andre the first immortal bio warrior in the world, but the experiment has failed on him. Throughout the video, they suspect that Andre is getting weaker and that he needs Shishi's blood for his body to regenerate and survive. Meanwhile, inside Andre's aircraft, Andre starts the procedure on Shishi. He extracts blood from her and infuses it into himself. In the middle of the procedure, Shishi tells Andre about the memories that come with infusing the blood, saying that the nightmares will make him go insane. At the same time, Chow Su, Lee Sen, and Lin Dong, disguised as the woman in black, and her guards while infiltrating the aircraft. They reach the laboratory but are unable to reach Shishi due to a protective screen that surrounds her and Andre. Lin Dong watches as Shishi begins to turn pale while Andre's body regenerates. Shortly after, Andre's forces arrive in the laboratory, causing another battle between them and the trio. Lee Sen pretends to be unconscious before shooting the men in black. Chow Su uses martial arts to fight off the remaining forces, while Lin Dong throws an explosive device toward them. Right after the trio defeats the men in black, Andre is forced to fight them amidst the incomplete blood transfusion using his newfound strength. The three continuously throw attacks towards Andre, but are unable to cause him any damage. Lin Dong glances at Shishi, and the two look at each other while Shishi weeps in agony. He strives to get up for Shishi, but Andre overpowers him. However, since the blood transfusion is interrupted, Shishi's blood regenerates, giving her enough strength to break free from the protective screen. She attacks Andre just in time before he kills Lin Dong. Chow Su and Lee Sen follow, and the four attack Andre simultaneously. During the attack, Andre accidentally infuses his blood to Lin Dong by stabbing him with an injection needle. With their combined efforts, the four drop Andre inside the aircraft's nuclear reactor. However, he tightly holds on to Lin Dong's arm. As the aircraft malfunctions and overheats, a huge explosion breaks out and destroys the laboratory. Andre ends up dragging and amputating Lin Dong's arm as he falls in the nuclear reactor. Shishi and Chow Su assist Lin Dong while they run away from the laboratory. In the middle of evacuating the ship, Lee Sen is caught in the explosion. As the remaining three rushes out of the aircraft, Shishi briefly reunites with Lin Dong while Chow Su prepares their parachutes. Shishi looks at his severed arm and hugs him while crying, pleading with her father not to leave her again. Just then, Andre emerges behind Lin Dong and strangles him. During the struggle, Lin Dong pushes Chow Su and Shishi, allowing them to escape using the parachute. All of a sudden, he starts seeing memories of Dr. James, Shishi, and Andre all together. As it turns out, Lin Dong's body has reacted to the bioengineered blood that Andre had injected on him. His amputated arm begins to regenerate as his body regains enough strength to counter Andre's attacks. Lin Dong punches Andre's chest continuously before ripping out the mechanical heart in his body. Another huge explosion in the lab forces Lin Dong to jump off the aircraft without any parachute. Fortunately, Shishi and Chow Su lightens the impact of his fall using their parachute. The three of them land on the ocean and survive. Sometime after the incident, Lin Dong is back in Australia with Shishi and Chow Su as they spend time together in an amusement park. Lin Dong learns from Chow Su about the true identity of Lee Sen, who turns out to be the son of the arms dealer killed by Andre. Lee Sen had chased down Andre in order to avenge his family. Coincidentally, Lee Sen was also one of Shishi's childhood friends in the orphanage, following Shishi out of goodwill and genuine attachment toward her. In the end, Lee Sen is revealed to have survived the explosion and is currently in another country. He has in his possession the tape containing Dr. James's detailed research, trying to find the best buyer around the world.